Hi guys, this is Shitijio. Today I'll be explaining to install Jenkins on your Linux machines and get started with it, creating a first Jenkins job. So let's go to Jenkins homepage, which is jenkins.io. You'll see this is the homepage. Let's download. So we'll click over here and we'll select the long-term support release. Now you have an option to select whichever Linux version you are using, so it will download, it will give you the installation instructions for that particular Linux flavor. We'll go for CentOS as I'm using Cloudera's virtual machine which has CentOS installed on it. So I'll select this. Okay, so now what we'll do is there are some commands that have been given that we need to execute. So we'll copy this command. And we'll execute it in the terminal. And the next thing we're gonna do is we will execute the next command, which is this, and we'll execute that. Okay, so that's done. The next step is to install Jenkins using the yum installer. So the yum installer works on Red Hat versions as well as CentOS and Fedora. So whichever you are using, we'll be doing it using yum installer. Let's see. Okay, so we got an error saying that we need to have root permissions in order to perform this command. So what we'll do is we'll do a sudo yum. Okay, so now it is asking whether we want to download the Jenkins package, which is approximately 62 MB. We'll say yes. So the download has begun. So this is gonna take a while. So I'll be back in 2 minutes. So the download is in progress. This is gonna take a few more seconds. Now it's installing Jenkins and the installation has been completed successfully. So we'll move on to the next step, which is to go on to this wiki link over here. As you can see, this line has this wiki link. We'll go over here. And over here, we'll scroll down and there we'll find the command to start the Jenkins service. So just copy this command and we'll execute it into the terminal. So let's start the Jenkins service. Okay, so the Jenkins service is on. And we'll also enable some configuration for Jenkins, which is done using this command. Let's execute that. Okay, so now the Jenkins service is on. Let's verify the same. What we'll do is we'll open the web browser and we'll go to this link localhost :8080, which is the port number for Jenkins, and see if Jenkins is actually up and running. So this should open up the Jenkins dashboard. As you can see that Jenkins is ready, it's getting ready and will be initialized in a few moments. Let's wait for that. So this is the Jenkins dashboard. We do not have any jobs created as this is the first calling Jenkins. So you can see this, that it's asking for creation of a new job. On the left, you will see some options. These are the menu items that are available to us. Let's create a simple job, which will be our first Jenkins job, by clicking on create new jobs. Over here, the job name I'll specify as my first freestyle job, and I'll select the freestyle project and I'll click on OK. So the next thing you can see is this is the configuration of your job. Here you can specify some description about the job, like this is my first Jenkins job. And we'll scroll down. And what we'll do is we will add a build step. Here what we'll specify is that we'll execute a shell command. So in this command, what I'll do is I'll specify the command that I need to execute. So I'll say hello Jenkins. So this is my Unix command that I will execute in my Jenkins job. So this is the simplest possible job. And what I'll do is I'll just save this job. So my job has been saved. And let me just do some configuration, but let's go to dashboard first. Over here, I'll go into manage Jenkins. Here we need to verify whether some plugins are available to us. If not, we will have to update the plugins and we'll have to install them. So we'll go into manage plugins. As you can see, most of the updates have already been made available to us. So we already have them, and we can select a few plugins from here as and when required, and we can install them. So those will get moved on to the installed list. So right now we don't need to install any plugin. As you can see that the Git plugin is already installed, GitHub API plugin has been installed. So most of the plugins that we will be requiring, the green balls, all the plugins have been already installed. So we won't be installing them again. So we'll go back to dashboard. And now what we will do is, we will build this job. So let's build the job and see what happens. So as you can see, this is the build number over here. In the build history, you can see that this is the build number and this is the status of the build. So it says that it's successful. So the success flag is green. Now the green ball, you might not be able to see the green ball, but you may see the blue ball. That's because by default, Jenkins has the blue ball as a symbol for success. We modified this by installing a plugin called Green Balls, so that you can do by going into the configuration of Jenkins, and you can go into manage plugins and you can select the Green Balls plugin and install it. So let's see some of the console output that was generated for this build by clicking on the green ball. As you can see that this is the console output. It executed this command hello Jenkins, and this was the output, and the status of that build hence is successful. So our first build was a simple shell script which had the echo command, and that was executed successfully. So the entire build was successful, hence the green ball. Now let's try to fail the build. Now what I'll do is I'll again configure this project It's loading. Yeah, it's loaded. And I'll what I'll do is instead of this, I'll try to, you know, break this command. So this should throw an error. Now what I'll do is I'll save it. So let me show you again what change I made so that the build should fail. So in the echo command, I removed one double quote, or you can do anything else, like you can add a D in front of this so that it fails by stating that no such command found. But we'll let it be, like we'll remove the double quotes. So let's see if this fails the build. And we'll click on build now again. As you can see that a red ball is generated for this build. The build number is 2, and you can find that the status is failed. Now let's go into the console output and see what exactly is the reason for the failure. So as you can see that the status is failure, and the reason is at line number 2 of the shell script that was executed, which says unexpected end of file while looking for double quote. So it went to execute the echo command and it couldn't find the second double quote of the string, hence the failure. Now we'll go back and we'll see in the dashboard, like what is the status. So the dashboard gives you a view of the project. It will give you a list of all the projects, like after this you may create another project or any number of projects. It will give a very nice view of all the projects that you have created so far with their statuses. So you can see that the red ball over here says that the last build of this particular job has failed, and this gives you the description, like how many builds have failed so far. So let's rerun this to check what is the description status of the builds till now. This is the current status. This is the entire description, like a summary of how many builds have succeeded or failed till now. This is the job name, and this is the last time whenever the build was run, last time when it succeeded, that will be shown over here, and last time it failed, that build number along with the duration, it will be shown over here. And this is to schedule a build from the all view. This is called as the all view. You can add another view and it will show you a separate view, like you can have a group of jobs, so you can create a separate view for each group. So you can do that. We won't be doing it now. What we'll do is we'll go back to Jenkins, and now what we'll do is we'll trigger a build again. So let's do that. And go into the job and see that the third build that we just triggered has also failed, and it has failed due to the same reason that was given in the last failure. So we'll go back to projects and we'll go back to dashboard, and we can see that the description of the builds has been changed from just clouds to rainy clouds. So it states that 2 out of 3 builds have failed, which is not good. So what I'll do is I'll again build it. So let's wait till the build gets completed. I think the build would have been completed by now. So let's enable this auto refresh. Okay, so the last failure is build number 4. So let's disable the auto refresh again. So you can see that the last build that failed was build number 4, and the status remains the same. like it states that 3 out of 4 builds have failed till now. So we can go into this job and check the status of the all the builds. This build history gives you a list of all the builds that have been executed till now, along with the date and time when it was executed. And you can go into the console output and see that it failed due to the same error again. And now what we'll do is we'll rectify the error and we'll build again. So let's see what happens now. So the first time this was successful, and the next three times I tried to fail the job and see the status of the Jenkins job in the all view. So let's change this and rectify the error. I have changed the code. Now it should build successfully because it should not have any error. So I'll build again. And you can see that on the left hand side over here in the build history, the symbol for this build is success and the build number is 5. Let's go into the console output. You can see over here that the status is success and it has executed Hello Jenkins. And this is the output. So the last build, which is the build number 5, is successful. And we'll see the dashboard. So you can see in the dashboard as well that the symbol of this job for the last build, which is build number 5, is green. So you can always check the statuses of all your jobs in one view, whether which job has failed and which job has succeeded in the last build. So that's it for now, guys. This was enough for the quick start of Jenkins. You guys try out some more stuff. You can explore Jenkins. I'll come back with some new session on Jenkins, trying to explore Jenkins for different types of jobs. Till then, goodbye. Thank you for watching.